Hello everyone, welcome to Decode ITES. This is a single learning platform for multiple IT infrastructure technologies. Do like, share and subscribe our channel to never miss out our videos. Let's continue with the learning. Let's have a small introduction of myself. My name is Prince Garg. I'm having 3+ years of work experience and worked on NetApp, VMware, Windows, Google Cloud, PowerShell, Python, and Bash scripting. Kindly follow us on Facebook, Insta, LinkedIn, and reach out to us on itesfun.com. Welcome back everyone to Linux 8 learning series. In this lesson, I will teach you about the groups in Linux. Also, I will cover with the practical session of how to create new groups and add existing groups or new groups to the user accounts. Let's continue. So in this lesson, we are going to talk about group membership. We have talked about a little bit already, but I want to summarize and make sure that we all understand everything there is to know about the group membership. So first, every user must be a member of at least one group, and that is taken care of automatically if you use the appropriate utilities. Only if you start working with the configuration files yourself manually and add users by editing the config files, you can make mistakes in there. Primary group membership is managed through the file etcwd, and the user primary group automatically becomes the group owner. If the user creates a file, this is something we will talk in much later, but for this course, which is about permissions, but already it's good to note that this primary group membership is important for files, because every file in Linux is a user owner, group owner and others. And the primary group is, I will just say, becomes the owner additional. The additional secondary groups can be defined as well, and the secondary group membership is managed through etc groups. To get a full overview of these groups that the user is a member of, you can use the id commands. Let me show you another practical overview session how this will gonna work, how the id command will work. So let's move to the practical overview session. We are having the command id. If we use id on test1, which is the user, we can see the uid is set to 1005 and the group id is also set to 1005. If we can see, it's having the groups like group test1 1005 and group wheel, which is the group id 10. Let's create a group. Let's say Linux. Oops, it's already there. We will create Linux1. So as we have created the group named as Linux1, if we would like to add the Linux1 group to the user, we can use user mod -a uppercase G and then the group name Linux1 and then the username test1. The group is now added as a membership to the user account. If we use id test1 again, what we can see here that Linux1 is added to the group section. We can also check this out under the etc parswd file. Let's go with it. We can do the grep on with test1 to the etc parswd file. So here we can see the IDs of the user account. If you would like to get the information related to groups, we can go to the etc group file. We can see all the information related to that user is there, and also the ID test1 result is similar to the same. So to start with the creating and managing groups, there is group add. Group add is a command to add groups. If you can see, the group add is having a couple of options as well, but basically we don't want to use these options because all of the options, if you can set through a group add, kind of useless. So if you want to create a group with the name, let's say group 1, just add the group add and group 1, and that's it. Second options are group del and group mod that can be used to delete and modify groups. We can use them what do we have with group mod? If we can check the group mod help, we can see the couple of options by ourselves that are not that very interesting. Just few of them, maybe the important question is which type of options are lacking from the group mode. If we use LID minus G group name, this is to list all the users that are member of a specific group. So let me cover this up in the practical overview session, and this will be a great thing if you check this out. Let's continue. So now let's move with the practical overview session, and we are having the first command, group add. If we use group add minus minus help, we are having a little bit of options over there, let's say 9 options, and these are not pretty useful. Also, these are not pretty interesting because we would not be able to use them on the daily basis. It's good if you are creating the group manually. If we use group add and the group name, let's say RHE. So the group is created. Now we are having the command group mod and group del. These are to modify and delete the existing groups. If we use group mod minus minus help, we are having 7 options listed over there. We can use them to modify the groups as well. These are related to the file permissions because under the Linux environment, every file permission is set to user, group and others. Next one is group del. Group del is a very simple command by which we can delete the groups. Like if we would like to delete the group we have just created, let's say RHEL, the group is gone. It's no more over here. And at the last, we are having LID command. We talk about the LID command is a very interesting one. Let me show you. If we use LID minus G and the group B, we can see it's showing that test one user is added to that group. Like it's having the group membership of wheel group. But this will not show all the details. Let me go through the etc group file. Now you can see that wheel group is a membership of test one. So that's all for today, and I hope you have learned about the group membership under the Linux environment. We have already discussed about the user's creation and managing the user accounts in Linux in our previous lessons. If you're having any queries, you can just reach out to us on itsfun.com, or you can drop a comment over here. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Do like, share, and comment our videos. Also, subscribe to our channel.